North America's first yearling sale for horses with turf appeal is coming to Fasig-Tipton. Selected yearlings by the nation's top turf sires. The Fasig-Tipton Turf Showcase presented by Woodbine Racetrack, September 10th in Lexington, Kentucky. Where will you be?
Dan Illman, Matt Bernier, race number 9 at Del Mar on Saturday is the Grade 2 John C. Mabee Stakes. $200,000 is the purse. Let's take a look at this field. Our coverage is presented by the Turf Showcase at Fasig-Tipton, a big and bulky field. It looks like a fun betting race. What are you going to do with the number 13, Goodyear for Roses, arguably the horse to beat based on a runner-up effort to Lady Eli in the Gamely?
I kind of want to be against her here. I feel like this is a prep for something else. I also hate the blinkers go on. I know they're basically a cheater blinker. They're nothing, you know, real substantial. I mean, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. That's kind of the way I look at it. But you also look at this race, and you know what's still ahead. They've shipped her to Keeneland in the past. I wouldn't be surprised if they tried to do that again. I just kind of look at it the outside post. I'm going to try to beat her.
I think there are enough things to try to beat her. The 3 months off, the blinkers, how will that affect her on the track? The outside post position for me, most especially. 7-2 on the morning line for Goodyear for Roses. It's possible she could go off shorter than that. Timeform U.S. pace projector is the one. Hill House High up in front. And Hill House High can lead. She can stalk. I think wherever Rafael Bejarano has her, it'll be in a pretty good spot from the inside.
Yeah, I don't think Tripp is going to be the thing that gets her beat. I wonder if it's just a talent standpoint. And I also wonder about a mile and an eighth. I think she's better going shorter.
Well, let's talk about the 3, Decked Out, because Decked Out's got some ability. She won the Grade 1 American Oaks on New Year's Eve. The problem is we haven't seen Decked Out since. She was supposed to start in a prep race at Del Mar earlier in the meet. She got sick. She missed the race. So she's coming into this race off an 8-month layoff, and she may need a little bit more pace than what the pace projector has in store.
And I think she's going to be right there, coming from the back. We know her game. It's also worth noting, you and I have talked about it numerous times. I mean, it seems like she really excels with a little bit of cut in the ground. She's not going to get that on Saturday.
The 5, Madam Stripes, looks to be in a pretty good position as our friends in Timeform U.S. have her, I believe, in 4th in the early portion of the race. Mm-hmm. She's in sneaky good form. I really liked her effort in the Wilshire 2 starts back. And Ola Gray just ran away and hit early, and nobody was catching her. Madam Stripes tried hard to finish 2nd, then benefited from a slight drop in class to win the Ocenitas over 2 next out winners.
I chased and chased and chased and got off for the Ocenitas, and then she goes out and wins, obviously. That's usually how it works. I thought she had a perfect trip, all things considered, but she did finish really well. I think you have to view her as a main contender.
I do think last time was the time, considering that the favorite in that race, we'll get to in a bit, Mrs. McDougal, was coming off such a lengthy layoff.
Agreed.
And might have needed the race. Now Mrs. McDougal has a race, and maybe she's just a better horse than Madam Stripes. We'll find out. Could be a good price for Madam Stripes one more time. You know I'm Pretty Girl's biggest fan.
Yes.
And it seems like there's always either a troubled trip, and you thought last time out in the yellow ribbon, Mike Smith waited a little too long.
Yeah, I wasn't entirely sure. It seemed, and maybe that's just her. Maybe she's only got that quick burst and you gotta wait as long as you can. I kind of feel like she got the shuffle. Had she gone on with a horse like Ambicelli, maybe she's the one that outfinishes. I'm not suggesting she was gonna win, but maybe it's a photo.
Friends If I'd returned off a lengthy layoff in the yellow ribbon, I thought got a decent trip and just lacked some pop in the lane. Was it due to her being short off the bench, or do you think she just wants a lot more distance?
I'm confused why she's here again. I think she wants more distance. I think she's a mile and 3/8, mile and a half kind, and she's not getting that here.
You really made a strong opinion for Ambicelli last time out. She ran well.
Yeah.
At 15-1, she got beat 3/4 of a length. Career best by her speed figure by a long way. How do you rate her as she stretches back out to a mile and an eighth? I'm giving her a mulligan for the last mile and an eighth race. She was coming off a long layoff, and she caught a very sharp horse.
Yeah, the problem is I don't know that she's going to get the pace that she needs. I think she's really would ideally get a big pace in front of her, and they take her back and make that one run. Keep in mind, too, you go back and watch that yellow ribbon. She was all out for about a half mile. Victor was getting the bat out. She ran just fine. I think you're going to get another comparable effort.
You and I chased Insta Irma for a bit.
Long time.
When she was on the East Coast for Bill Mott. Just missed last time out in a $100,000 race at Canterbury. The 4th place finisher of that race came back to win with an 89, then finished 3rd in the Grade 3 Violet with a 90 buyer speed figure. I think she's lightly raced enough that there's a forward move coming. She's now with Richard Baltus.
My biggest concern is the distance. I don't know if 9 furlongs is her friend. I know she won. She broke her maiden at 8.5, but there's a part of me that thinks that she's better at sort of 7 or a mile.
Barley Sugar did some really good things things when she first came to North America last summer, and perhaps her last race indicates that she's getting back on the beam. A 1 mile non-winners of two other than that resulted in a career best by her speed figure.
I think she's going to need to step forward. There's no reason that she can't as a four-year-old, second off the bench, but she's going to need to move forward.
Lady Velour is a multiple stakes winner, but she won by a nose last time out in a race that she had to win on paper, and she only got an 83 buyer at Santa Rosa.
Lady Velour is just the most consistent horse you're going to find. You're probably going to get an 85 buyer, if I had to guess.
Paolo Lobo's got Pretty Girl in here, and we talked about how she's had all sorts of issues, and she's certainly good enough to win a race like this. How do you rate Lobo's other runner, the number two, Kiss Me Now? Okay effort in her first start off a long layoff going 11 furlongs.
Yeah, she was impeded a little bit down the lane. I don't think it cost her anything, though. I find it fascinating that they turn her back. I think she probably wants more ground.
Let's talk about our top selections now for a really competitive edition of the Grade 2 John C. Mabee Stakes. You like Mrs. McDougall last time out. I understand completely why you go back to her, and she's going to be a better price this time.
Yeah, she should be a better price. I think she's third choice on the morning line. I'm hopeful with the other big names in here. Maybe she is 9-2, 5-1. The thing I have an issue with, Richard Mandela's numbers aren't particularly strong. Past year, turf second off the layoff and route races, 1-16. I just know that, and I know, look, everyone has every right to look at her and be like, hey, you know what, she's always goofy with the lead changes, maybe she's always been overrated. I do know that she has races on her page that can win in a field like this. And if I don't want Goodyear for Roses, for me, it's really two horses in here. It's Mrs. McDougall in Cambodia, and I'm hopeful that Mrs. McDougall just needed one off the bench. Mandela also said she is going to be much more forwardly placed, so if she takes up sort of a second or third position, I think she could get brave.
Cambodia beat four of these common rivals in the Yellow Ribbon on August the 5th. A mile and an eighth is somewhat of an unknown for trainer Tom Proctor, but she is in good form, and I really like her tactical speed. She's 9-2 on the morning line. I wouldn't take anything less than 4-1, but I would use her, and I would use my old standby, the 9, Pretty Girl, as well. You're going 6, 4, 13, and 11 in the John C. Mabee. It is race number 9 at Del Mar on Saturday. Best of luck.